ओके स्क्रीन विजिबल है, स्टार्ट करें।
यस सर, यस सर।
ओके सो लास्ट लेक्चर में जो डिस्कस किया था वो अंडरस्टैंड हुआ सभी को, समझ आया बड़ी सिस्टम किस तरह से काम करता है मेमोरी मैनेजमेंट में। अगर उसमें कोई डाउट हो तो डिस्कस करें। किसी को कोई डाउट नहीं? ओके सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 34 एंड वी हैव स्टार्टेड यूनिट नंबर 3। दिस इज मेमोरी मैनेजमेंट पार्ट 2 एंड इन दिस सेशन वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ मेमोरी पार्टिशनिंग टेक्निक्स, हाउ वी कैन मैनेज मेमोरी if any programs or any process occurs by the users. So this is the question format. This kind of questions may be asked in GTU exams. Like state various memory partitioning technique and compare them in terms of their strength and weakness. We have to explain the various partitioning techniques and we have to compare their strength and weakness, their positive and their negatives. Which one is good, which one is best and which one is worst. What is partitioning? Explain memory partitioning techniques. This kind of straightforward question may be asked in GTU exams. So let's understand first what is memory partitioning. Why we need to do the partitions of memory? Why operating system do this kind of things? In the first multi-programming system, an entire program was loaded into its own block of memory called its memory partitioning. जैसे मैंने आपको बताया था कि इसके पहले जो यूनि प्रोग्रामिंग और मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग का जो सिस्टम था उसमें सारा प्रोग्राम्स जितनी भी मेमोरी अवेलेबल होती है उसमें अब लोड हो जाते हैं। तो जो भी मेमोरी ब्लॉक अवेलेबल होते हैं वो प्रोग्राम्स उस पूरी मेमोरी को एंगेज कर लेते हैं, ऑक्यूपाई कर लेते हैं। यदि हर एक मेमोरी हर एक प्रोग्राम एक एक मेमोरी ब्लॉक को यूज करता है तो उस छोटे से ब्लॉक को बोला जाता है मेमोरी पार्टीशंस। दीज अर्ली सिस्टम्स इंप्लीमेंटेड मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग विथ फिक्स्ड पार्टीशंस। पहले मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग सिस्टम में इस तरह से इम्प्लीमेंट किया गया था कि हर एक पार्टीशंस को फिक्स कर दिया गया था। बिकॉज द मेमोरी पार्टीशंस आर फिक्स्ड, दैट्स वाई इट इज कॉल्ड फिक्स्ड पार्टीशनिंग टेक्निक। This is important terms, you have to understand what kind of partitions it is. So if we have given a block, memory block, and we have to divided each block into a fixed size of memory, like let's understand by the diagram, fixed memory partitions. Fixed partitioning techniques. Let's suppose This is the primary memory location, primary memory blocks. Let's assume that this is the kernel locations. First of all, operating system will be loaded into the primary memory. It will take the bottom of the memory, or maybe it will take the top of the memory blocks. So you can consider either top or bottom. This is kernel, or you can say Windows operating system. So keep remember, the kernel or operating system programs always resides at the bottom of the primary memory or at the top of the primary memory, depending . So let's suppose this is bottom of primary memory. Now let's suppose the entire size of primary memory will be, this is the entire size of primary memory. Size of primary memory, let's suppose 1 MB, or let's suppose 100 MB, for example. So if we have given a size of 100 megabyte size of memory blocks, then suppose we want to convert into the fixed partitioning technique, each and every program must have the equal size of primary memory. So somehow we have to divide the entire memory locations into fixed size. So suppose we create first partitions of 10 MB, then 10 multiplied 10 is equal to 100. So in this way, we have to design the 100 of block. Let's suppose block number 1, block number 2, block number 3, block number 4, 5, and so on. I hope you understand. And point is to be remember, each and every block having the size of 10 MB. So it is very simple memory partitioning technique, as you can understand in the diagram. Fixed partitioning technique, that means we have to allocate each and every block with the fixed size. No block having the less capacity, or you can say the less storage capacity, and other one having the greater storage capacity. Each and every block having the fixed size of locations, fixed size of memory blocks. So if we do this kind of partitioning technique, then this technique is called fixed partitioning technique. So we have each and every partitions, and every partitions having fixed size. So this becomes the definition. We have n number of partitions. We have n number of partitions. And each partition have fixed size of memory. kind of partitioning technique is called fixed partitioning techniques. So that is the definition of a fixed partitioning technique. Operating system resides on top of the primary memory and bottom of the primary memory. It depends on structure of CPU and motherboards. So we always call that the resident program, which is the kernel programs or operating system files. It may be take place in the bottom of primary memory and it may be take place in the top of the primary memory. So it depends on the structure of motherboard and CPU. Now, if we talk about the allocation of primary memory, so allocation of fixed size of block or partitions to requested process. So whatever process that are requested for a memory that want to execute in the primary memory, it must be stored in the partitions. If the size is compatible with this partition, then memory will be allocated to the process. If size is not compatible, then memory will not allocate it to the process. So this is the limitations of fixed size partitions. If the process requested size of memory is less than availability, then it will be allocated to the process, otherwise it will not. So let's understand by example. Suppose there is a process number one, and it is requesting 8M memory block or memory partition. Then we have to check the fixed partition size, what we have available. So we have available 10M and the requesting is 8M. So can we allocate or not? So according to our comparison, requesting process 1 8M memory block and availability of 10M, so we can allocate process 1 requesting 8M memory block. In that case, availability is 10M. Therefore, we can allocate 10M to process 1. So this is how a fixed partition technique works. I hope you understand. As the size of program grew, it becomes difficult to find partitions large enough to accommodate programs and still have the multiprogramming level high enough to produce a good CPU utilization. Now, types of partitioning technique is fixed partitioning technique, dynamic partitioning technique, simple paging, simple segmentation, virtual memory paging, and virtual memory segmentation. So here we have take the introduction part of memory partitioning. So this is a memory partitioning. Question may be arise why we need to design a partitions. So the simple answer of this question is we want to store more than one program into a primary memory. That's why we required partitions. Suppose if we do not have a number of partitions, then the single program can occupy the entire memory locations. Just wait. Okay, so let's continue. So that's why we required partitions. So suppose if we do not have a number of partitions, if we not design the partitions to the available size of memory, then there is only two sections of primary memory. First one is kernel resident program, and second one is user resident programs. And if user resident program having the bulk of size of primary memory, it engages the large volume of primary memory, then the small request can occupy the entire memory. This is the drawback of a uniprogramming system. We have already discussed in the previous section, previous lecture, what is the drawback of uniprogramming system. So we want to utilize the memory. We want to store more than one program into the primary memory. And in that way, we have to utilize or getting the higher throughput of CPU. That's why we need to do partitions so that we can allow to store more than one program into primary memory. So this is the concept of partitions. Multiple partitions can be there, and resident programs is also there, and each and every partitions having the fixed size. So this is a fixed partitioning technique. And who will do this kind of techniques? Who will do this kind of partitions? So the answer will be operating system having one department called memory management. So memory management will take care all these things. Now let's move ahead. According to the partitioning technique, if we start dividing the memory, primary memory in different partitions, we can have number of memory techniques like fixed partitions, just we have seen. Second one is dynamic partitions. We will discuss after that. Then it is simple paging and simple segmentation, virtual memory paging and virtual memory segmentation. So fixed partitioning, we have already discussed each and every partitions having equal size. Any process whose size is less than or equal to the partition size can be loaded into available partitions. If it is not so, then we are not able to load a process into the primary partitions. The operating system can sweep a process out of a partitions if none are in the ready or running state. This is the nature of operating system. It will be swept out to the process that are not longer used that memory locations. So it will be swept out by the operating system. A program may not fit in a partitions. The programmer must design the program with overlays. Now, the conditions may be occurred. Suppose if we have available the 8M memory partitions and the program requested to 10M. So there is two partitions will be allocated directly to the process that required 10 megabyte block. And this is called overlays. If two partitions simultaneously allowed to a process, then it is the concept how it will be allocated to the programs or a process, then the concept of called is overlays. Main memory use is inefficient. This is the drawback of memory partitioning technique. The main memory use is inefficient. Any program, no matter how small, occupies the entire partitions. Let's understand the diagram. Let's understand the inefficiency of fixed partitioning technique. Suppose there is a process P2 that requires only 4M. Only 4M size of memory partition. Then we have designed equal size of partitions because we are following the fixed partitioning technique. We cannot customize the size of partitions. We are not allowed to do these kind of things. So process P2 requests 4 megabyte size of memory. So anyhow, we have to allocate the block having the size 10 megabyte. So let's suppose we allocate first block to our process P2. And process P2 resides here. Process P2 resides here. But only 4 megabyte block will be used and rest 6 byte of block will be remain. This is the process P2. And the rest part will be remain empty. So this empty part cannot be used by a different process. If we available 6 megabyte in the first partitions, then we are not eligible to allocate 6 megabyte to the different process. So let's suppose if process P3 is there and it is requesting it is requesting 4M size of partitions block, then again, suppose we have empty 6M block, again, we are not eligible to allocate these 6 megabyte block to the process P3 because it is not allowed in the fixed partitions. Each and every partitions having only a single process, can contain by the single partitions. More than one process cannot enter or use that single partition's locations. So this will not done. So if you want to utilize the fixed partition technique, we have to design such kind of process or program that required 10 megabyte memory partitions or less than 10 megabyte, but not it will be less than to 8 megabyte or 9 megabyte. Then we can say we have utilized the fixed partitioning technique. Otherwise, it generates the less throughput and it is called inefficient way of allocating to the memory. So main memory used inefficient. So how it is inefficient, I have described to you. Any program, no matter how small, it always occupy the entire partitions. If it is the equal size of partitions, then it will utilize the entire partition. Otherwise, the entire space that are empty in the first partitions or any partitions, it will not used by other process. And this is called internal fragmentation. This kind of problem which we have discussed to you, this is called internal fragmentation. Let's understand again. We have allocated P2. We have allocated 4 MB to process P2, and we have used first partitions. So availability of this area will be 6 MB. Right, but this 6 MB is not further used by any program or any process. So this empty space cannot be used by any program or any process. This is called internal fragmentation. Internal fragmentation. And this cannot be resolved by any technique. So you have to understand what is partitions, what is fixed partition, what is internal fragmentation in fixed partitioning technique. Sometimes in 2 marks is a question, what is internal fragmentation? So you have to describe in this way. Suppose if we have given a fixed partitions, let's suppose the size of fixed partition is 10 MB. There is a process P2 that requests 4 MB. We have to allocate it, suppose first block to the primary, first block to the process P2. It will engage only 4 MB. The rest of memory is 6 MB that are empty, but it is not allocated to different process. So this kind of problem is called internal fragmentation. Now solution is you have to make the partition unequal size. This is only the solution of internal fragmentation. Otherwise, internally we cannot manage the empty space of a fixed partition. So the solution of fixed partitioning technique, or we can say solution of internal fragmentation, is just to divide partition that are variable size. Program up to 16 MB can be accommodated without overlays. Smaller program can be placed in a smaller partitions and reducing the internal fragmentation. So the solution of internal fragmentation is you have to design memory partition in such a way that each and every size having the unequal partitions, unequal size of partitions. So it may have some less size of memory partitions, some may have larger size of partitions, and then understand the request of process. If process having the less size, we are searching only those partitions which having the less size, and suppose a process requesting to the large size of partitions, we have to search those block which satisfy the process request. So we have to searching before allocating memory partitions to the process. This is only the way how to increase, how to make efficient the memory partitioning technique. Now the second technique was a dynamic partitioning technique. So let's understand dynamic partitioning. Partitions are of variable length and number. We can have n number of partitions, and each and every partitions having the variable length. Variable means there is change of memory partition. Suppose first partition was 14M, second one was 6M, third one was 4 MB, 8 MB, 18 MB. So entire primary memory locations will be divided into different number of memory blocks, and each and every blocks having different size. Partitions are of variable length and number. Process is allocated exactly as much memory is required. So this is how we utilize the entire memory, because we are allocating memory block to the process, but before allocating we are comparing such blocks whether it is satisfied to the memory requested or not. So process is allocated exactly as much memory as required. Now let's understand. The second partitioning technique was dynamic memory partitioning technique. So again we have a memory, there is a resident programs is always resides maybe top or bottom. So this is kernel resident program. And this is user programs area that will be divided in dynamically. So let's understand, this is the first block. This is the second block, may have different size or variable size. This will again the variable size. Third block. So we have total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 block, 5 dynamic block, and each and every partitions having different size. Again, as you can see in the diagram, let's suppose this is 5M, this is 15M, this is 8M, this is 25M. And this is suppose 18M. So we have n number of partitions block, each and every partitions having variable size, some blocks having size M, 5M, 15M, 8M, 25M, 18M. If we add all the blocks, if we add all the memory partitions, then we can get the entire memory, entire size of primary memory. Yeah. Now let's suppose the process comes. Process P1 request suppose 10M of size. Suppose process P1 request to the 10 MB memory block, then before allocating to a part, before allocating any partition to the process P1, we have to use some algorithm. Let's understand. Okay, so let's continue. This is the dynamic partitions. And suppose allocation of partitions can be done by some algorithm. Best fit algorithm, first fit algorithm, and next fit algorithm. So randomly we are not allocated to the allocated partitions to the process. We have to apply some algorithms. This algorithm is first we will take first fit algorithm. Next fit algorithm and third one is best fit algorithm. So there are three algorithms that are used to allocate or that are used to search a proper memory block, memory partitions based on request. Based on process request. So you have to understand what this kind of memory algorithms. This is algorithms for allocating memory partitions to process based on request. So process की जो भी request होगी उस request के base पर हम इन तीनों में से कोई एक algorithm चलाएंगे और multiple blocks में से उस block को हम final करेंगे जो उसके लिए applicable होगा. हम रेंडमली कोई भी ब्लॉक उसे अवेलेबल नहीं कराएंगे क्योंकि यदि ऐसा करते हैं तो उससे ज़्यादा मेमोरी वेस्टेज हो सकती है. राइट, फॉर एग्जांपल यदि हम 10 मेगाबाइट प्रोसेस की रिक्वेस्ट है P1 प्रोसेस की, अगर हम फर्स्ट ब्लॉक एलोकेट कर देते हैं तो वो इनफिशियंट है. 5 मेगाबाइट के मेमोरी पार्टीशंस में 10 मेगाबाइट का प्रोसेस का कॉन्टेक्स्ट नहीं आ सकता. अगर हम 15 मेगाबाइट अवेलेबल कर देते हैं तो 15 मेगाबाइट और 10 मेगाबाइट में 5 मेगाबाइट का अभी भी डिफरेंस है. बट हो सकता है कि 15 मेगाबाइट से लेस साइज वाला ब्लॉक नीचे अवेलेबल हो, तो हमें सारे पार्टीशंस को सर्च करने होते हैं. सर्च करने के बाद हम बेस्ट एप्रोप्रिएट पार्टीशन निकालते हैं और फिर उसे हम एलोकेट करते हैं प्रोसेस P1 को या रिक्वेस्टेड प्रोसेस को. सो इस तरह से ब्लॉक को सर्च करना फिर एलोकेट करना, दिस इज कॉल्ड एल्गोरिथम्स. ये एल्गोरिथम के बेस पर होगा. सो नेक्स्ट सेशन में हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे फर्स्ट फिट एल्गोरिथम कैसे काम करती है, नेक्स्ट फिट एल्गोरिथम कैसे काम करती है, एंड बेस्ट फिट एल्गोरिथम कैसे काम करती है. सो डायनेमिक मेमोरी पार्टीशनिंग टेक्निक में ये बात ध्यान रखनी है कि सारा मेमोरी, जो प्राइमरी मेमोरी का जितना भी यूज़र प्रोग्राम एरिया है जहाँ पर यूज़र के प्रोग्राम्स आते हैं, एग्जीक्यूट होते हैं, उन प्रोग्राम को या उस प्रोसेस को हमें जो मेमोरी एलोकेट करनी होती है वो वेरिएबल साइज़ की रहेगी. और वेरिएबल साइज़ एलोकेट करने से पहले हमें सारी मेमोरी को वेरिएबल साइज़ में डिज़ाइन करना पड़ता है. यह ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम का काम है कि वो अवेलेबल मेमोरी को किस तरह से डायनेमिक पार्टीशंस करके रखे. और जब डायनेमिक पार्टीशंस हो जाते हैं, कई सारे पार्टीशंस बन जाते हैं, हर एक पार्टीशन की साइज वेरिएबल होती है, फिर हम प्रोसेस की रिक्वेस्ट को देखते हैं, एनालिसिस करते हैं और फर्स्ट फिट एल्गोरिथम के बेस पर यदि हम पार्टीशंस को एलोकेट करना स्टार्ट करेंगे तो वो जब मैं एल्गोरिथम आपको समझाऊंगा तो आपको क्लियर होगा कि हर एक प्रोसेस को फर्स्ट फिट एल्गोरिथम के बेस पर किस तरह से पार्टीशंस अवेलेबल कराने हैं। अगर हम नेक्स्ट फिट एल्गोरिथम अप्लाई करेंगे पार्टीशंस को एलोकेट करने के लिए प्रोसेस को, तो आपको वो क्लियर होगा कि किस तरह से नेक्स्ट फिट एल्गोरिथम इस पर अप्लाई होगी। और अगर हम बेस्ट फिट एल्गोरिथम अप्लाई करेंगे तो अब आपको क्लियर हो जाएगा। तो नेक्स्ट सेशन में हम लोग तीनों एल्गोरिथम डिस्कस करेंगे और डायनेमिक मेमोरी पार्टीशंस में अवेलेबिलिटी जो है हमारे पास और रिक्वेस्टिंग जो भी है उन दोनों को हम सेटिस्फाई करने का ट्राई करें। सो दिस इज द बेसिक इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ डायनेमिक मेमोरी पार्टीशनिंग। इसको हम कंटिन्यू करेंगे नेक्स्ट सेशन में। थैंक यू सो मच।